Hey, what's up with everybody? I hope everybody had a nice Christmas and looking forward to the new year, 2020, baby. I know I ain't been on here in a long time. I guess last time I was on here, it was, I guess, in regards to the Mason Rudolph getting hit by Myles Garrett with the helmet and all that. But I guess I wanted to maybe catch up, give an opinion about our quarterback situation headed week 17 here in, down here in Baltimore. First off, you know, again, second year in a row, we don't control our own destiny. We got to hope for somebody else to help us out. And that's all our own doing. Started week 15 at home with Buffalo. Opportunity after opportunity. And we blew it. Basically turned the ball over five times, six, if you would have counted, basically a botched punt, a shank. So, two straight games, and then a piss poor performance in New Jersey against the Jets. So, I think pulling Hodges was the right move to do. We needed a spark, and to be honest with you, the only two times I really thought Mason Rudolph looked like he showed he's got potential is the two times that he came in not as a starter, but coming off the bench as, in relief. When he didn't expect to come in, when Ben messed up his elbow, he played pretty good against Seattle, really, really well. That was the best, to me, that was the best he's ever looked. And it just went gradually, slowly downhill. And he looked good to me against the Jets. He wasn't overthinking anything. He was pulling the trigger. And he looked pretty sharp. Everything looked like it was on time and in rhythm. And that's what you're looking for. There's still some, still some accuracy issues. Still him, you know, double clutching, patting the ball a little bit. And not, you know, again, him overthinking everything. And I still don't like that, you know, as far as him, his mobility. But he did show a little bit of pocket presence a little bit. He was able to step up and avoid the rush. I do like that. And maybe that'll get better over time. Just don't know right now. But the one thing I've been claiming, you know, when Ben went down, I wanted to see everybody. Because to me, I understand we think Mason might be the future. And you know, whatever, even though we took him in the third round of steal, we have a first round grade. Everybody thought he was going to go in the first. I understand all that. But at the same time, that doesn't guarantee that you can be undrafted. Can be, again, Tom Brady, six round pick, best to ever do it. Or you're talking, I mean, or it could be a first round and he just pans out. You don't know, but you can't just all of a sudden assume. You got to let these guys play out. Okay? So, that was all for playing Duck. You know his deficiencies. The problem with Duck is obviously his deep ball. His deep ball has more hang time than the best punter in the game, and you can't have that. I mean, it's time and time again. And it's like, hey man, I mean, if you don't have the arm, he's put too much air under the ball, and you got to throw it sooner. I mean, you could have a safety literally play on the other side of the field, literally come on, and you have one safety. You only got to play two safeties back. It could be a single high safety. And his ball has so much hang time on it. It's like a lame duck, dead duck, that they just come right over across and jump up and pick it off. Just jump right front and pick it off. You can't have that. That's his arm strength. His mobility's not too bad. His pocket presence has gotten worse. He's rolling out when he don't need to and then run, you know what I mean? It's here or there. But with Mason, same thing. He can't move, but he's got an NFL arm. He's got a good arm. Okay? But there's the one thing I want to talk about. Is all the hate. Why all the hate for Paxton Lynch, man? I mean, I've been clamoring for this guy. I want to see all these guys play. That way we can see what's behind Ben, what our future could be. If we don't have the quarterback on the roster that could eventually replace Ben, we need to go out and look for it. Maybe not next year. Hopefully Ben comes back fully healthy next year for two more years. And then we can worry about it at that time or see how he's feeling at that time. But that's the thing. All I see is all these people. I mean, I heard one guy on Behind the Steel Curtain literally talk about he'd rather punt and then hope our defense can score and cause turnovers than let see Paxton Lynch score. Why? 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 Josh Allen's getting all this hype. He's not, yeah, again, he's making a few plays here and there. He's still, but yet we see where Buffalo's at. If you look at Paxton Lynch, he's got the same body type as Josh Allen, who was a first-round pick by John Elway, 6'7". Rocket arm, and he can move. Okay? Out of any quarterback draft in the first round, he's got the least amount of starts. So to me, we're all talking about, oh, well, Mason's only has 7-8 starts. Oh, we can't judge him. Well, what? About, why is this guy getting thrown in like he's a bust? Oh, what? Because Denver decided, say, a 7th-round pick was beat him out, or Case Keenum beat him out. That's their opinion. We weren't behind closed doors there. Okay? He hasn't got another opportunity. We brought him on the practice squad, and he's been slowly learning. But it's like, look, to me, why not start him? We've already seen what Duck can do. 6 interceptions in a 5-quarter span. Come on. We saw Mason's struggles. The one thing that this guy's both got, that Mason has a good arm, can't move. Duck can move, but don't have a good arm. This guy can move and has a good arm. He's got both qualities that the other one lacks. So why, and then with a defense like we got, 17, 20, even 20 points, you're most likely going to win the game. So him just extending the play, that's how Ben made his name. That's how Ben was so successful when he was a rookie. He didn't pass more than 20 times, but he was able to play backyard football, extend the play, then basically guys break wide open, and he's able to hit them. Again, you know, he didn't become a precision passer and get the ball like that until later on, years down the road. When he first broke in, it was his big plays pretty much were off broken plays and him breaking out the pocket. And again, cornerbacks can't cover forever. 3, 4, 5 seconds, they're going to break open and then also break off those routes, and then he can make a big play downfield. So that's all we need from a guy like Paxton Lynch. Why not see what he can do? Okay, we already know what this guy can't do. So Mike Tomlin's favorite saying, oh, I'm not going to live in my fears. But yet, in his last press conference on Tuesday, what did he say? Oh, well, they asked about Paxton Lynch. Well, we know his pedigree. I mean, first round, but we're not too familiar with them, and we don't have much comfort with that. Well, we can't worry about comfort, bro. We already know what this guy can't do, man. Okay? And the defenses are going to sit there and bait him to do that. Stack the box, everything inside, make him throw outs to the sideline and out to the deep passes and then deep balls. And bait him into those INTs. Duck hasn't made the adjustments on none of this at all. Okay? So, but yet, okay, so you're telling me why an undrafted guy, and we're going to keep bringing that up, but when you talk about a former first-round pick, the way they talk about Paxton Lynch, you would have thought he's undrafted. Why not give this guy an opportunity? He could be the real deal. You never know. Everybody's career don't take off just like that. You could have somebody that all of a sudden they takes off, and then all of a sudden somebody might need a fresh start somewhere else. And okay, whatever. So why not see what this guy's got? We have nothing to lose, man. Okay, we already know what Duck's going to give us. Duck's not going to give us nothing. Duck's going to throw lame ducks and get picked off. Okay? And I've already heard in practice that Paxton Lynch is fitting balls that, like you said, that people shouldn't throw, and he's fitting them in the little holes. We need that. All he needs is a couple big plays, him extending, score a couple touchdowns. We haven't scored 2 touchdowns on offense, I think, since the Cleveland game or whatever. We need something, man, or whatever. And why not give this guy an opportunity? I've been clamoring for the guy. I mean, I actually was watching film with him in Memphis. I wanted us to draft him, but what did we do? We take Artie Burns. So we saw how that panned out. I was clamoring for us to draft this guy back when he's come out of college, and we didn't. So I'm hoping this Sunday, you know, like that, whatever. I don't want to see Duck, to be honest with you. You know, like that, whatever. I want to see what, you know, be honest with you, I mean, I pretty much figured if Paxton's still on a team, we wouldn't see him until next preseason as far as real game action. So, and I don't want to wait that long, man. Be honest with you, somehow if we got lucky and got a Court of America and made the playoffs, I'd rather see Paxton Lynch play. Mason's already out. He's already on IR for the rest of the year. Paxton Lynch has more qualities. It's not even close. He's got that first-round pedigree that Mike Tomlin said. So why are you living in your fears, Mike? Stop living your fears, bro. You talk about, you know, we're not going to live in our fears. Well, your fear of him not knowing the playbook is why you're not playing him. Because I guess you're telling me, hey, if you knew the playbook, you're going to start Duck Hodges over Paxton Lynch? Explain that. That's what I want to know. You know what I mean? Hopefully, I mean, I'm going to watch. I got no expectations, man, to be honest with you. I'm kind of looking forward to getting this year over. I mean, I'd love for us to make the playoffs, man. Anything can happen, you know? But we did it to ourselves, man. I'm not going to sit there and sweat it, you know. Hopefully we can keep this defense intact. And hopefully Ben makes a full recovery. And you know, and we can compete, because I sure as hell get tired of, you know what I mean, if Ben should have all the motivation in the world. He's too old. You got people calling him a fat slob. All this talk, man. So like he's some bum, like whatever. And he's getting too old to do it. But yeah, you got Drew Brees out here, 40 years old. Tom Brady again, 42. Come on. So hopefully, I believe in Ben. Like I said, we didn't have this type of defense. We got this type of defense now. We'll see what happens Sunday. But I hope everybody had a nice Christmas, and I wish everybody a happy new year, and I'll talk to you soon. All right, have a good one.